Hello student, in the previous video I had taught to you about map making and how to read a map. Today we will continue with the same chapter, chapter number 9, types of maps. So all of you open page number 83. Today we will study about scale of a map, colors in a map, layout map. So we will start first with scale of a map. A map scale shows the relationship between distance on the map and actual distance on the earth's surface. Okay, what is a map scale? A map scale shows the relationship between distance which is shown on the map and in reality on the earth. Now we will read what is the scale of a map in detail. See in your book. When we look at the map of India, we know that Mumbai is towards the southwest of Delhi. But it is difficult to determine the actual distance between them. To make a map useful, map makers establish a relationship between the distance of places on the map and their actual distance on the earth's surface, and this is known as scale of a map. This relationship between actual distance and distance on a map is shown in the form of a map scale. Okay, now see to the given picture on page number 83. In first picture you can see 1 centimeter map distance and actual distance 1 kilometer. So what does it mean? It means that this distance of 1 kilometer, which is on earth, it will be shown on the map with 1 centimeter. There it will be written on the map, 1 centimeter is equal to 1 kilometer. Understood? It may be possible that two places on the map look very close to each other, but in actual they are quite far from each other. There are two types of map scale. First one is verbal scale. Verbal means what is said orally. A statement is used as the map scale. For example, 1 centimeter represents 100 kilometer. It will be told to you orally or anywhere. That is known as verbal scale. Next scale is known as graphic or bar scale. See on page number 84, here given a picture on the top. 2 centimeter is equal to 1 kilometer. Means if in a map it is written 2 centimeter is equal to 1 kilometer, it means that whatever 2 centimeter showing on the map, in reality, on the earth, it will be 1 kilometer. Understood? Now, your next topic is colors in a map. Okay? Different features of a map are shown using different colors. Okay? For example, brown is used for showing mountains. Blue is used for showing water bodies. Green is used for showing forest and greenlands. So, see on the same page number, sketch of Africa showing different physical features. This is the layout of this is the physical map. I told you earlier, physical map is show physical features of a place like mountains, rivers, plateaus and other landforms. Okay. Now see in the map, blue color denotes here different water bodies. Different water bodies, rivers, sea, lakes, ponds, etc. Green denotes plain areas like lowlands or agricultural lands, as I told you. sets of brown or violet are used to show highlands. As you can see, yellow shows highlands or lands higher than the plains or desert. See, Sahara Desert, Kalahari Desert. So it's not complete yellowish. Dark brown color is used to show hills and mountains. See on the top, mountain and hills showing with dark brown color. So different colors on map shows different features to make us understand anything on the map very easily. See, next topic is given in your book, signs and symbols. Okay, beside colors, map use a set of internationally recognized signs and symbols. Internationally means signs and symbols which all countries or maximum number of countries should know. Okay, that is known internationally. Okay, these symbols show different landmarks like temples, mosques, churches, roads, rivers, etc. Capital city, main city. Okay, see, a city is marked on a map by a small circle. As you can see on page number 85, symbol on a map given. Okay, first one, see, international boundary shows 1-2 dot, state boundary -1 dot, like this, district boundary --, metal road, double line, unmetal road, double --, --, line, railway, as you can see here given the picture, river, capital city 1 dot and 1 circle out of this, means 1 dot in a circle, town, single circle, forest, see, just like a small tree showing, bridge, for bridge this symbol is used, temple, this symbol is used for temple, you can also see church, symbol of mosque, police station, PS, capital PS, so police station, okay, post office, PO. These symbols will help us, symbols and skill are very useful to understand a map very easily. Okay, your next topic is layout of a map. Arrangement of the parts or areas of a building which is shown on the map with a symbol, that is known as layout of a map. Layout of a map shows us about the various section of a historical site at one glance. At one glance means in one site. Let us look at the layout map of a famous monument in India. Which monument we are going to see? Layout map of a Konark temple. See in the picture, Surya chariot. How is it showing? See, as you can see beside the picture, key given for one number for Surya temple. See in the picture, one number, then second number, Maya Devi temple. See second number in the picture showing Maya Devi temple. Okay, like the same way, Vaishnav temple, dance pavilion and kitchen. These all are shown with the help of numbers to make you understand easily. The Konark temple is in Odisha. It is a temple of a sun god. Okay, so now you have to do homework, and your homework is to read the lesson carefully and solve the exercises by yourself, and then match it when I will send you PDF. Thank you.